Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome to Car Question. You previously saw the exterior review of that MX-5. If not, well, feel free to check in the description. But right now it's gonna be about the interior of that car. Well, what do you need in a summer car? Some storage compartment for your beverage, a good connection with your iPhone to put your favorite song, a good sound system to raise the volume and pull down the tap to enjoy that nice sunshine. So let's go discover the interior of the Mazda MX-5 RF. Let's take a look inside that Mazda MX-5 RF. And remember that we have the Grand Sport package. So right now, this is Napa leather seat with Kudo stitches. What do they mean by Kudo stitches? If you take a look right there in the middle of the seat, you can see these unique stitches that will go all the way up to here. So this is really nice when you compare to regular stitches on this side. And these stitches are perfect. And if you can note also, you've got some little hole right here in the seat. And this is a speaker right there. You've got the Bose mention right here. So remember that if you're using voice command, you're gonna hear the voice through that section. And if you raise the volume, you're riding top down, well, you're gonna hear your favorite music through that speaker also. So right here in the door finish, it's plastic, but it's the same solar red as you're gonna see in the exterior color of the car. You've got the handle, really nice, good finish. Same thing for the leather around here also. And you've got that carbon look right here for the door command knob, for the windows and for the mirror. And you've got the speaker and really a limited storage space there. When you look also at the seat base, well, you've got some different cushion to adjust the height of the seat cushion, and you've got a handle if you want to move your back section of this seat forward. You can move it forward or reverse, but you cannot use any cushion to raise or lower the seat. That would have been a great and interesting feature to have. So when you take place inside, look at that, how deep it is. So this is really a low car. You're gonna be sitting really close to the road, so this is gonna get This is gonna give you a great feeling, but oh, it's kind of hard to take place inside though. You need to make some maneuvers with your body to be sure that you fit inside. And another little thing is right here on the side, you can see that big bulb coming out. It might be in the way of your passenger. Sometimes you've got the same little bump right here on the side though for the driver, but it doesn't interfere too much. So really nice display, really nice use of material that you're gonna see all the way up to here. So this is nice leather, nice stitches once again. Same thing for the top right here, plastic, but seems of great quality though. So let's press on the start and stop feature. Once, let's press twice. You're gonna see the Mazda warning, the display right here, the press clutch pedal to start engine because we have a manual. And that's what I like about this little sports car, manual 6-speed, that's a great thing. So what you have in that display is a 4.6 inches full color TFT display, which is gonna give you drive info, compass and roof status also. So you can press the info button around here. So remember that at the top, you see the temperature, you see the trip A, trip B, average, and you will see the instant fuel consumption. You even got some cruise control feature on the right side, external temperature, the full mileage of the car, and the fuel reserve that you have left. So you can press the info button and change the different display around here. So quite simple. And when you're gonna use the roof, you're gonna see that display change also. So right here, this is the handle for your lights. And by the way, let's turn them on. There you go. You can see right here on the side. So we've got all the information for the traction control, the TPMS set button. You've got the blind spot monitor and the lane change alert system. Voice command, by the way.
Say a command.
Help.
Available commands are entertainment, communication, Navigation, settings, applications.
Entertainment. And it's gonna bring me right there in the menu. So why not raise the volume? Remember that we have a 9-speaker sound system. Not too bad with the bass. Remember that we have address speaker also, so that's kind of cool. So you've got your phone right there, command that you can use. And if you press on that button, you're gonna see the display simply change to your call history. Cruise control around here, and you've got all your handle that you need to use the wiper feature. Nice steering wheel, just the right size. The only downside, you can adjust it, so you pull handle below, you can adjust it, but you cannot. It's not telescopic, so why did they do that? I would have loved to have maybe just a few centimeters to adjust to my perfect sitting position. But material, once again, great. So remember that we already did a video of the Mazda Common system. This is a 7-inch screen, so this is really cool. And it's one of the good systems out there that you can use by going into application, by going into entertainment, selecting the different music. Some people even use some Android Auto and reflash that system. So if you want to check that out for the complete review of that system, well, feel free to go and click on the high right there in the corner where you can see that video about this cool Mazda Command system. So really complete, one of the great system out there. So let's look right here. You've got some vent that you can turn on or off. You've even got another one right here, which is square. You've got the climate control temperature, and by the way, this is going to be useful if you're going to ride top down and let's say it's around 14 or 15 out there, so you can really compensate with the temperature and you're going to be okay inside. So if you wear a coat, that's going to be even better. So way down there, you're going to get the button to open and close the roof. You will have the display also around here, and the heated seat are right there on the side. Two USB connector, you've got also one auxiliary connector, and you've got an input there to put a little card. You've got some storage space, but it's really a joke. You don't get a lot of storage space though. So right there are the key, really typical Mazda style. So let's get to the great feature of that car. So this is the button to open or close the roof. So 13 seconds, it's really quick. So all you have to do is press up. And look at the cool feature that you get right here when you open it. So you can see exactly where your top is, and when it's going to be done, it will make that sound. There you go, operation complete. So it was not long, and you can enjoy the nice view out there of the top down. And let's close it though. And by the way, when you're going to close it or open it, you've got that yellow display right here on the side. And look at that, how quickly it's gonna get and simply close. There you go, the hook and everything like that, and it's done. So the only downside though is that your windows will always remain with that gap. So don't forget to raise both windows if you go away. So if you don't want some rain in your vehicle, that will be a must. So mirror is kind of big though right here, so you got the home link feature that you can use, but since it's big, it's gonna probably be in the way. So when you're gonna do a right maneuver and turn that way, the mirror will be in your way if you're tall or a big guy as I am right now. So while checking the top right there, you can see some plastic mirror though. That's kind of probably the cheapest part around here. So we've got a 6-speed manual transmission, and this is one of the great transmission out there. This is probably one of the best one. Really easy to shift. You can do it with your finger. It's precise and you can do it quickly. And when you're gonna move into reverse, well, you just do that and don't expect any rear view camera because there's none on this car. Nice stitches right here. Leather once again, handle brake. You want to do some drift maneuver. And by the way, if you want to control the Mazda Command system, you can use all the feature around here and the volume right here. Not a bad sound system. Remember then when you're riding top down, this is really perfect. So 9-speaker premium Bose audio system. So you've got some storage compartment around here. So if you raise that, you only have some space for food
and just a small bar and a cable and your phone. And when you close it, that's about it. So if you're riding with a passenger and you have two phones, well, too bad. So you can simply remove the cup holders, and they're not big. That's the problem that you have. So if you want to remove them, you can put them in the storage compartment over here, which is lockable, by the way. But also, if you want more easy access to your drink, you can put it right there in that section right here on the side. So take some time, you push hard, and there you go. You make sure that this is holding in place, by the way, because if it's not going to hold in place, you're going to have probably some spills around here. And there's no glove box, by the way. Storage compartment missing once again. But hey, what you have is right here to replace that. So it's lockable. It's deep enough to put your glasses. But still, why should I need to do that bad movement of turning myself and calling my chiro to help me fix my back? So you've got a CD player right here, another, and I don't know, it's not a good place to put it. And the cup holders will be in your way when you're gonna try to simply enjoy some music if you're old school and CD style. So we are gonna open the trunk by, where is my trunk button? Right here, it's kind of low, and I'm gonna pull open the hood. So nice display once again of all the features out there. So let's go check that trunk. And remember, with the trunk, even if you got top up or down, it doesn't change a thing to the space in the trunk. So not too bad. You've got the tire repair kit, because don't expect a full size spare tire in the trunk of this car, because you won't have any. No rear view camera, I'm kind of sad. Still looking great with the lights here. Let's get to the hood. And we've got the 2.0 liter SkyActiv technology engine from Mazda, which is going to be good for 155 horsepower. Look how they mounted that engine. You will have less loss of power because this car is rear wheel drive. So through the transmission, through the shaft, and look at the sway bar. Perfect for rigidity, perfect for road and lane. If you want to check the oil, it's right here at the top of the car. Washer fluid right here on the side and the battery. So let's say that you start your car during the winter and it doesn't want to start because you forget the battery, it's going to be easily accessible. So, aluminum hood sound. I really love the interior of that Mazda MX-5. It's really looking unique and in some kind of way exotic. The build quality is there. You've got great materials inside. That leather seems of good quality, but it's missing some adjustment for the seat. And how about a glove box for some stuff? Anyway, I really love that styling of the car inside. How about you guys? How about the Bose speaker right there in your headrest? Cool thing, huh? You don't have to raise the volume too much to hear your favorite song. I want to know what you think, guys. Feel free to comment in the section down there below. And remember, the next part is going to be about specification and road handling. So do a thumbs up because you like that video. Don't forget to subscribe to Car Question. And remember, we will have another video soon for you. Take care.